This will be delightful. Having the hero of Shaymor on my arm will make tongues wag.
Thank you for letting me join you this evening, Countess.
I'm always willing to do what I can for Queen and Country. That being said, let me offer you some unsolicited advice. First, mingle. Speak to everyone. You never know who'll say something they'll regret later. Second, don't limit your conversations to nobility. Servants and guards see everything.
Understood. I suppose it goes without saying that I should be discreet.
You catch on fast. Go on and charm the masses. You know where to find me if you need me, pet.
Would you care for an appetizer?
Oh.
How can I help?
You shouldn't drink so fast. You're going to get sick.
Mind your own business. May I offer you a drink? Would you care for an appetizer? May I offer you a drink?
Come now, Lady Madeline. Everyone knows you're an expert in the intricate workings of your brother's mind.
Not of late, I fear. Between his duties as minister and my own duties tending to Mother, I fear we've grown distant lately.
My condolences, good lady. I meant no offense. How is your noble mother?
Somewhat improved, but she remains in poor health. I beg your pardon, my lord. May we speak of happier matters?
Would you care for an appetizer? Excuse me, do you have a moment?
Ha! My shipment finally arrived. It was delayed in transit.
Would you care for an appetizer?
Spoil like an abomination's captured the trading post.
You're lucky it wasn't ransacked.
May I offer you a drink?
Here's your drink. To anyone watching, I'm just a kind-hearted noble, and you're just a grateful guard. Now speak your mind.
Burglaries and kidnappings are increasing, yet here we sit, idle. Lately, the guard is never where it's needed most.
That drink was meant to loosen your tongue, but you still sound like you know more than you're letting on.
I heard what you did in Shaymore, and I know you've got Thackeray's ear. What I'm telling you could get a man killed, so use it well. Our orders arrived just before the raids. It's as if someone is sending us away so bandits can swoop in unchallenged.
You think there's a deeper connection? Someone in the Ministry Guard working with the bandits directly?
Higher than that. The orders come from Minister Zaman himself. Look, I'm taking a big risk here, but those bandits are scum. Please do something with this information.
I will. Now, enjoy your drink. I've got someone I must speak with.
Would you care for an appetizer?
I'm thrilled to be invited to one of Master Wee's parties. It's so elegant.
I know. No one else has his refinement and wealth.
Yes, wealth helps. A lot.
This place is amazing. The gods have truly blessed Minister Wee.
Where is that server?
Would you care for an appetizer? May I offer you a drink? Would you care for an appetizer?
Speak quickly.
May I offer you a drink?
May the Six watch over you.
May I offer you a drink?
Oh, look at the Countess, will you? Such a beauty. She has the entire room in the palm of her hand.
Did you know she's a history buff? Ancient Krita is her subject of expertise. Would you care for an appetizer?
Yeah.
May I offer you a drink? Would you care for an appetizer? Huh.
Hi.
You've been a busy little bee, haven't you? I presume you've gotten the information we need?
More than I had hoped. I've identified witnesses who will testify that Zaman had dealings with bandits.
How lucky. I'd love to throw Zaman in a cell, but politics have my hands tied. At least with this evidence, we'll be able to call him to trial.
Aha. Speak of the fiend, and he appears. Logan, it seems Minister Zaman has arrived. You're free to do your duty.
If it isn't Logan Thackeray. I'm sorry, Captain Thackeray. To what do I owe the honor?
As Captain of the Seraph in the service of Her Royal Majesty Queen Jenna, I call you to trial.
What? This is an outrage. I demand to know the charge.
Treason against the crown and citizens of Kryta. May Cormyr judge your words justly, and may Duena have mercy on you.
Long live the Queen.
Halt, citizen! Ministers only beyond this point.
Thank you.
I haven't had this much fun since I discovered the agriculture minister was stealing truffles.
I remember that blustery old fool. He swore that his pet pig had dug them up by accident.
The tricky part was telling him from his pig. Now then, my young friend, are you ready to present the case?
I've gone over everything a dozen times. Unless something goes horribly wrong, we'll get our man.
At this rate, Queen Jenna's guaranteed to notice you. If nothing else, I'll make sure your name reaches her ears.
Minister Codicus is waiting. Signal him when you're ready. Good luck. And may Lyssa bless you with unparalleled eloquence.
Royal servant of the crown, but if Zaman gets off, I may have to take matters into my own hands.
I would have thought the entire Zaman family would be here.
His mother is bedridden, though I did see Lady Madeline.
Oh, I didn't see you there.
The Seraph have overstepped their bounds.
I agree. Accusing a minister of treason? It's preposterous.
Hear ye, the trial of Minister Julius Zaman is hereby called to order. Legate Minister Codicus presiding. Who stands for the prosecution?
I do. Your Honor, we have evidence proving Minister Zaman conspired against the citizens of Divinity's Reach. He abused his authority to commit thievery, murder, and treason. We will present incriminating documents and sworn testimony from respected members of the community, including the accused's own sister.
The prosecution seems to have prepared quite a compelling case. Minister Zaman, can you refute these dire accusations?
Refute? Why bother? My Lord Codicus, in accordance with the most ancient tenets of Crichton law, I invoke my right to trial by combat.
This court accepts your invocation. By law and custom, you may choose a second to fight with you in the circle.
Thank you, Legate Minister. I choose my retainer, Idol of the Unlovable, as my second.
The prosecution must also nominate a principal and a second, or forfeit the case.
I will be the principal, Legate Minister. I'd like to request a short recess to select my second.
Granted. When the prosecution is ready to continue, this court will reconvene and the trial by combat will begin.
As a Seraph captain, I can't really jump around saying, pick me, pick me. But I can certainly think it.
Thank you.
Aye.
What are you doing here? I didn't know you were interested in judicial matters.
Thackeray had me identify Queen Selma's stolen chalice this morning. I'm curious about its relevance in this trial.
You never fight alone.
We're ready to begin, Legate Minister. I've chosen my second.
An interesting choice. For the record, let it be known that this duel will continue until both members of one side surrender or are defeated. If Lord Zaman proves victorious, he is innocent. The case is thrown out and these charges against him may not be brought again. If you win, then Zaman is found guilty of this crime.
I understand.
When you're in position, the trial by combat shall proceed. Good luck to you all. May justice prevail.
End this. Kill them both. Let's be done with it. Your skill is no match for my cunning. I am a minister of the realm, and you are nothing. Die!
Victory is declared. According to the dictates of Crichton law, Minister Zaman is found guilty.
Minister Codicus does not look happy.
He doesn't like anything to infringe on the rights of ministers. Trial by combat took the judgment out of his hands.
Did it? How do you think Zaman knew about the ancient law in the first place? He's no historian.
You think Codicus advised Zaman about the clause?
If Zaman won the battle, he'd be declared innocent. No more investigation. Now he's guilty, but he's also dead. No loose ends. Never underestimate Minister Codicus.
At least we know the identity of Zaman's backer. Go and celebrate a well-earned victory. Anis and I will be in touch with you.
I was genuinely hoping for a conviction based on a preponderance of the evidence. Yeah, but this works too.
Thank you.
Balthazar strengthen you.
Greetings. Good to see you again, my friend. You have excellent timing. Have you ever heard of Falcon Company?
Falcon Company? Of course I have. One of the most decorated units of Seraph, wiped out by a Centaur ambush. My sister was a soldier in that command.
Your sister? I'm sorry to hear that. I didn't know. You'll be even more interested in this information than I thought. Scouts in the Queen's Forest discovered pages torn from an old journal. They were apparently written by Willem Harrington, a member of Falcon Company. The writing on the pages is rough, hasty, but it describes survivors of the battle taken prisoner by the Centaurs.
Survivors? My sister could be alive? Logan, you've got to let me investigate. I need to know what happened to Deborah.
I thought you'd feel that way. Let's update my records and then you can head to Elven Monastery and speak to Captain Tervellin. Though he's been promoted to Captain of Queensdale, Tervellin once commanded Falcon Company. He might be able to tell us more.
What is it?
May the Six watch over you.
Speak quickly.
What is it?
Good to meet you.
Where did he... Ugh.
Good to see you again, my friend. You have excellent timing. Have you ever heard of Falcon Company? I'm on duty.
Don't let them get the tools back to their cave.
Lock it. I wonder what they needed the tools for. If they would just ask, maybe we'd trade with them.
According to Grint, we're in for a safe journey.
Thank you. The citizens of Beetleton are harried by the constant threat of centaur attacks. Many have moved to the city to avoid being captured by centaurs, who take their captives to a prison camp in the eastern hills. Tunwatch does what it can, but even the Seraph can be defeated.
Hostile if we shared our beer with them.
I think they want our land and crops, not our beer.
Just a thought. More for me then. What can I do for you?
We must all stand against wrongdoing.
Knowledge is the greatest treasure. And Cormier and Light.
Let's see the color of your coin.
The hero of Shaymore is finally here, everybody. The captain's expecting you. He's up on the wall.
You must be the hero Thackeray warned me about. He says you're investigating the Falcons. That true?
Yes. Captain Thackeray said you'd help me. Have you heard anything about Centaurs taking prisoners?
Thackeray's been swaddled in the royal court for too long. He's forgotten how rough it is out here. You wasted a trip. Falcon Company is long gone. May Grinth have mercy on their souls. Go home, kid. You're in over...
Centaurs! At the North Gate! Get the monks inside! To arms!
Right on schedule. Come on, hero. You're about to learn what it's like outside the city gates. To the North Gate! After you.
Push them back!
I don't want them inside the walls. See what he wants.
Bring out the hero. I am Hrud the Reaver, pillager of human lands. I will kill any human who claims to be stronger than I. Let me see this great hero of Shaymore, I've heard has come to die beneath my hooves!
I wonder how he found out you were here. That's unfortunate. You can sneak out the back if you like.
I challenge you, hero of Shaymore! Reveal yourself!
They get a good fight! I better see some fancy moves.
Balthazar will protect you, my child.
Slay this vermin.
Please, in the name of all six gods, tear his wretched heart out.
my backup? Has the captain lost his mind? I expected an entire squad! Have our orders. Smash the weapon class, lure the centaur to the end of my life. Prisoner's belongings inside that cage near the tent. Check it out. I'll cover you. The only reason I followed you in there was because you're you. I didn't even think we'd survive, but you were great. Hey, what did you find?
A soldier's journal, half buried in the cage. It has the Falcon Company insignia on it and a list of survivors inside. My sister's name is there, Deborah.
I thought Captain Trevelyan said there were no survivors.
Trevelyan may be lying to cover his tracks. The book accuses him of setting the company up to be attacked by centaurs.
I don't know what to think. Trevelyan, a traitor? You don't think he sent us out here alone to die, do you? He hasn't been happy with me lately.
It's a distinct possibility. But don't worry, Bigsby. We'll get to the bottom of this together.
Of course you're still alive. Should have known a few centaurs couldn't kill the hero of Shaymor. They're your specialty after all, right?
I know what happened to Falcon Company, Trevelyan. How could you give them up to the centaurs? How could you betray their trust like that?
I didn't want to do it. My soldiers were starving. Our equipment was ruined. I had to do something or the centaurs would have killed us all. So yeah, I sold out Falcon Company so that some politician could say the Queen was a bad ruler. The rest of my command lived. I got funds to re-equip my soldiers, munitions, decent rations, and a promotion. My command's killed more centaurs than the rest of the Seraph combined, thanks to Falcon Company's sacrifice.
And all it cost was one company of your fellow soldiers. You're not an officer. You're a greedy low-life thug. And you'll pay for what you've done.
You and Bigsby. You hadn't dug so deep, you both could have done a lot to help us. All of us. But now you'll just be etin' food. Bigsby may be already. This gate should hold you all in. I'm sorry it came to this. Goodbye, hero. When you meet her, tell your sister I said hello.
Thank you. Trevelin is
coming. Put down! We're so close!
There goes Trevelin.
You all right?
Fine, Captain Thackeray. I'm glad you're here. Trevelin's a traitor. On top of two fresh counts of attempted murder, he was the one who betrayed the Screaming Falcons.
Bixby's letter said as much. And Trevelin kept insisting no one was in the cave. A bit too strongly for me to believe him. I'm glad you made it out.
Captain, I think Trevelin knows something about the survivors of Falcon Company. I need to ask him a few questions.
By all means. Anything he can do to help redeem himself would be in his best interests. Life in prison can be rough on a traitor. You hear that, Trevelin? You'd better answer my friend's questions. It's a long way to prison, and the road can be very uncomfortable.
Ha! Oh! Mm-hmm.